Hey beauties, this is Sam from Instant Beauty Hair Extensions. So this video I wanted to talk about the 16 ways that you might be damaging your hair without even knowing it. Bum, bum, bum. So the first one is wind. It's summertime and really warm in Toronto this year. And unfortunately my car air conditioning broke. So for a few weeks I had to roll all my windows down. I would come home and I would have like matting in the underneath part, and it was just very, very dry. It made all my ends very dry. And I was thinking about why this is. And then I realized it was because of all the wind coming through the car and how damaged it made my hair. So if you can ever avoid having your hair loose, if you're in the car, like a convertible, or if you're on a boat or somewhere where it's very, very windy, I would highly suggest putting your hair up or in a braid or something just to avoid all the damage. So the second one is chlorine. This is big for swimmers or for people going on vacations. Chlorine is and triple worse for extensions, but just even for natural hair, chlorine is a very, very, very harsh chemical, and the hair absorbs it and very, very much dries it out and can make it very brittle. So it can even change the color if you're blonde. So I suggest, you know, if you really, really have to go swimming with your head underwater, to wear a swim cap, or to just put your hair up on the top, at the top of your head and not go under. Or at the very, very, very least, as soon as you're done swimming, jump in the shower and condition the crap out of your hair just to try and repair the damage from the chlorine. The third one is dyeing and bleaching your hair, specifically bleaching your hair, because the bleach removes the pigment and leaves the hair very, very dry and brittle. And I mean, it could be done very carefully, and if it's done professionally, you know, minimal damage can be caused. But sometimes if you're jumping from color to color, especially going from dark to light, you can very most likely experience some damage. So the next one is over shampooing. Now, so a lot of people wash their hair every single day, and I hear from clients all the time that they wash their hair daily. Sometimes it's okay, but especially if you're shampooing vigorously on the ends, it's very, very drying. If you begin to train your hair to, you begin to train it to wash it less frequently, then you'll notice such a big difference, and the natural oils will begin to come back into your hair and make it much, much more moisturized. And you'll see a lot less breakage or damage to your hair. So the next one is brushing too roughly and ripping out your tangles. I mean, we've all been there. It's like, you know, 2 minutes before you gotta go and you realize you haven't brushed your hair yet. So you do it really quickly, or you have a tangle and you just get so frustrated and you just rip at it. Obviously this is damaging, and I'm sure you see in your brush how much hair is in your brush. But the reason why it's really, really bad is because every time you break your hair that way, you're left with an end that is so sensitive, I guess, to split ends, which can cause even more damage, and the shaft continues to split all the way up and then eventually just breaks off, and that's how you end up with having such short broken pieces. The next one may seem a little bit obvious, but some people don't have a choice because they love to have their hair straightened because their hair is naturally curly, they love the straight look, or vice versa, their hair is pinned straight and they have to have the big waves all the time. It looks gorgeous, but every day heat styling is a big one for damaging your hair. And the best thing to do is to use a low heat setting if you're going to do it every day, or try to do a style that can last a couple of days so you don't have to constantly be using heat on your hair. Or even better, use a heat protectant spray before you use the heat. So the next thing that can damage your hair is getting your hair permed or chemically straightened. So, I mean, I can't even tell you how many times people have told me that they've gotten their hair straightened and now their texture is not the same anymore. I can't say I'm a big fan. I mean, I can't say that it works phenomenally well, and it's not really worth the long-lasting damaged results, if that makes any sense. Those chemicals are quite harsh, so even left on one extra second can fry the crap out of your ends. So if you can avoid that, avoid it. If not, be very cautious and use a lot of good treatments to repair any damage. Okay, so the next one is having a ponytail too tight all the time, putting your hair up in a ponytail when it's wet. I've actually done this, putting your hair up when it's wet, too tight, go to bed, wake up, and your hair is a disaster. And your hair gets so tangled, and when it's wet, it's so susceptible to breakage. So having a really tight hair tie on it, really at all, is damaging. So you want to be careful. You want to use a good hair tie that won't pull on your hair too much, and you want to try not to put it up when it's wet. Okay, the next one is getting bad extensions, or how can I say this? Having them put in incorrectly or not taking care of them properly. Extensions are one of the most damaging things if not done right. If they're done right, they're okay, but definitely if you have already very damaged hair, I would suggest really doing your research before getting them done in a place that is inexperienced or you're not sure what product they're putting in your hair, because it can go wrong. So you do want to do your research. Okay, so the next one is, I would call, double styling. This means basically, like, let's say Friday night you have your hair curled, ton of hairspray. Saturday night you want to go out again, and you want to change your look completely. If you don't wash and dry and condition your hair in between the double styling, and then, you know, your hair is just really, really, really susceptible to breakage, because you're using heat tools on hair that's already has that's already been styled and already has product on it, like hairspray, for example, and that can really, really hurt your hair. The next one is sun damage. So we all know that the sun is quite damaging to our skin, but it is also damaging for our hair. The sun can dehydrate our hair, and depending on your hair type, that can really cause breakage. So the sun is everywhere, and you know, I'm not saying don't go outside, but you know, especially if you're the type of person who's outside a lot or works outside, you should take precaution. So the next one, and kind of touches on my other point about shampoo, is you should try and find the right shampoo for you. There are a million, gajillion different types of shampoos out there. You know, ones for different hair colors, hair textures, you know, different things you may do, like a perm-treated shampoo or color-treated shampoo, things like that. You do want to find the one that's best suited for you. I know this maybe seems a little bit of an obvious point, but there are a lot of times where you don't realize how dry your hair is, and then you're not using a moisturizing enough shampoo, and you realize that you need to use like an entire bottle of conditioner. And then, you know, I mean, obviously that probably means you're on the wrong shampoo. So you also want to make sure that you are paying attention to your hair and seeing if your hair is getting used to the shampoo that you're using. Sometimes you might find your hair becomes alive again if you find a new shampoo. Changing it up is always good. And you do want to make sure that if you do something different with your hair, like you all of a sudden now you've bleached it or you dye it, you do want to get the right shampoo for you. Okay, so you know how they always tell you clean your makeup brushes all the time, you know, because bacteria and like skin residue and stuff growing in there that could probably you know, make you break out, stuff like that. Same goes for your hair tools. You need to clean your brushes, because the same thing goes, the same as the makeup brush, it goes for a hairbrush. So it's really important to clean your brushes, because you don't want to be leaving leftover product residue in your hair, or bacteria, or, you know, I mean, then it's just gonna cause your hair to get greasy, and then you have to rewash your hair, and then you're just, you know, doing this big cycle of like damage, and it's not a good idea. So the next one is something that probably everybody's guilty of, rubbing their hair when it's wet. So like getting out of the shower and getting your towel and, you know, rubbing it like this. That is so damaging to your hair, because the friction that you're causing can leave the hair so dry and brittle and frizzy. So, you know, really try to just blot with a towel if you're going to, or even just sort of like gently squeeze out the water and let it kind of dry by itself. So the next damaging thing that we all do is not brushing our hair with the right tool in the right circumstance. So like for example, if your hair is wet, you want to use a wide tooth comb for sure. You don't want to use a brush that can pull at your hair or cause any more split ends if you have any. The best thing to do, especially when your hair is wet, is to use a wide tooth comb and gently comb tangles out. So my final point, and probably my most important point, my most talked about point to like everybody, is you have to cut off your split ends. So if you ignore your split ends or your damaged ends, then you will continue to have damaged ends and probably make it worse. But if you're looking at your end, you'll see either it's a little bit broken or it's like one hair shaft is turning into two or three, and that's called a split end. And the thing is, once it splits, the hair becomes very, very, you know, weak. As soon as it's brushed, the pieces that are split can break, and then you'll just progressively see how your hair continues to get shorter and shorter and shorter because it keeps breaking off. We're not trying to be mean, but you know that really is the only way to repair a damaged end. Even you, I mean, you could try and give yourself treatments and stuff, and you may repair it a little bit in the way to make it healthier and stronger of the hair shaft. But the end that is split will still split and may continue to split and go up higher and higher and higher, and your hair will get shorter and shorter and shorter. Okay, beauties, well, that was my big ginormous list. I hope I taught you guys a few things. If you have any questions, please leave them below, or any comments, of course. And it's good to see you guys again. Talk to you soon. Bye. Right?
She just said it. You should be like this. No, move your mouth. Hello, my name is Samantha, and I am beautiful. Did you know that I love going to the zoo? My favorite. Okay.
Did it look right?
You were doing a pretty good job with your hands there too. You're still Italian.
La la la. Okay. Pizza pie.
It's a Mia Samantha.
Okay.
It kind of sounded more like Count Dracula.
Yeah, that's so mom.
Oh, one. Ha, ha, ha. A two. Okay, three.
Any goofs now?
Yeah, three. Good.
Okay.
Woo!
Woo!
The cycle of damage. Sounds so evil.
Dun, dun, dun.